Hello folks, welcome to 17th edition of Chit Chat. So today me and Prashant will talk about two different setups. So I will be talking on options and how to trade super trend using options in Nifty. Okay, this is only specific for Nifty. So Prashant will talk about his setup after I finish it up. So recently I talked in eTechnoc on how to trade total open interest using options. So this one is also pretty similar to that. There are some slightly different changes, but overall the concept is very similar. So super trend, you know, many of you know this indicator is most widely used by people for trading both intraday as well as positional in stocks as well as indices. So today I'll focus only on Nifty and how you can use this super trend trading signals using options. So we can use either 5 minutes or 15 minutes time frame depending on whether you want to trade intraday or positional. If you're using 5 minutes, then you will have more signals. So you can do more intraday trading if there are in small changes in direction of the market. So you can stay with those small trends in the market. But if you use 15 minutes, you'll get slightly, you know, longer trends. So you can do positional using 15 minutes time frame. Of course, you can use any other time frame as well. So according to you, what is suitable time frame? So you can change that according to your risk appetite or how many number of trades you want to take in a day or in a week. So you can change or you can tweak that setting, time frame setting, according to that. So we will use Nifty continuous futures to plot super trend. So we'll use the default parameters that are available. So here I'm using the default parameters that are available in trade point. And so in this case, we will use only weekly options of Nifty. Okay. So we start the positional trading. So here I'm taking 15 minute time frame. So it will be positional trading. So we will start positional trading on every Friday morning, 9:30 a.m. Okay. So we buy or sell the option in the direction of the market. So we are staying with the trend. So if the trend is buy trend, then we'll buy the option. And if it is sell, then we sell the option. And I'll tell, you know, like when to buy option or when to sell the option. If the super trend signal is in buy, then buy call option or sell put option, right? We are bullish in this case. So both are achieving the same result. That buy call option is bullish and sell put option is also bullish. And if super trend signal is in sell, then buy put option or sell call option. So both are bearish in this case. Now, I will tell you when to buy option or when to sell option. Now we buy options when the VIX is below 14 and we sell options when the VIX is above 14. The reason is that when the VIX is below 14, there is not much premium in the options. Okay, there is not much theta decay in the options. So you can stay with the trend and buy options and you will not lose much because of theta. But when the VIX is above 14, then your theta might be high. And therefore, it's ideal to sell options in that case. Like, you know, in the current market conditions, when the VIX is almost 18, so it makes sense to sell options because there can be theta decay in the weekly options, right? So we take advantage of theta decay as well. So the one signal reverses. So let's say you're in buy position. And if the signal reverses, then we exit that earlier position. And we enter a new position. So this is a kind of short trading, a stop and reverse. So enter new position means we are changing from buy to sell. So once the market moves by 200, so let's say you are in particular direction and the market has moved 200 points, then you move the strike by 200 points. Okay, and I'll show with example simulations on how to do this. So we rinse and repeat till Thursday expiry, this part. So we'll always, so in the case of a sell option, okay, we always keep a hard stop loss on each trade, as well as a positional stop loss as well. So in this case, I always use 4,000 as my stop loss for the week. So per lot, 4,000 loss. So around 80 points based on current lot size. So the moment I see 4K loss, I exit my trade and my position for that week. Okay, I'll get out of that trade and I'll wait for the next week, the next Friday to start my trade. And also you have to keep this stop loss always in the system, because recently we are seeing these freak trade losses where suddenly the market goes up by 100, 300 points. So you never know what will happen. So always keep that hard stop loss of 80 points, no matter what, just to avoid some systemic issues with the market. All right. So let's take examples. So here I will show for 2 weeks. In 1 week there was a trend, like in the last week, in the 21 October expiry. And the 14th October expiry, there was market was kind of sideways and trending both. So we'll check both of them. Okay. So we go back here. We go to 21 October expiry. So we get ready for simulation here. So since in the 21 October expiry, the Friday was a holiday on 15th October. So we start on Monday. 9:30 we start. Okay. So now first let's look at the super trend signal. So this is on 18. So the buy signal is when it is your candle or the closing price is above your super trend, right? Mm-hmm. So now this is in buy position, buy mode. So this is 9:15 candle, which means from 9:15 to 9:30, this is the candle.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so this is a 15-minute time frame.
Mm-hmm.
So if you want, so these are the parameters that we use. Period is 10 and the multiplier is 3. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So these are the parameters we are using. So now we are in buy mode. So now at close, the market is around 18,507. So 18,500. So you can see here when I hover on this, 18,500. So now we will sell an at the money put option, right? So we are bullish and the VIX is above 14. So we have to sell option in this case. So we sell a put option, which in this case is 18,500. So here, okay.
Mm-hmm.
So our stop loss is always 80 points. Hard stop loss is 80 points and positional stop loss is also 80 points.
Mm-hmm.
So whenever we see a loss of 4,000 here per lot basis, we'll exit our trade and for that week. So, okay. Now let's look at here and see when the signal has reversed. The signal has reversed the next day around. So this is around 10, right? So 10 means the closing point will be 10:15. So around 10:15, the signal has changed. So we have to change from that trade here at 10:15. So now next day we go to 10:15, but before that we have to check if we are losing any money when this has hit the highest closing period. So here around on 19th, 9:15 candle, the close was 18,574. So we have to check whether we have hit any stop loss at that point of time, right? Just to make sure that we are doing it right. So we go to 10:15, right? So here we have not hit any stop loss. So here the signal has changed. So we exit this trade and we reverse it. So now the closing of this is 18,457. It's so 18,500 again, roughly. So now we have to sell a call option here. Okay. So the call option that we will sell is around 18,500, something like that. Okay. So we go here. 18,500 call, because we are bearish here. So here we'll sell this.
And okay. Selling option because this is above.
Yes. So and we have to check. See here again, after entering this trade, the market went above. So we might be in loss. Well, we might hit stop loss. So we have to check that part. So around this is around 12:30. So 12:45 close, we have to check if we have hit stop loss or not. So just to make sure that, you know, we are following the rules.
Right.
Okay, so 12:45 we'll check. Okay, so we have not lost anything here. Okay, so 4000 was our stop loss hit, right? So we didn't hit. So after that, the market went down. Okay. Now here you can see, you know, everything went fine. So your call would have done well, the sell call. But at one point, the market has went down by more than 200 points, right? If you look at the rule here, if it moves by 200 points, we have to move the strike. So here, so we went from 8,500 to 8,300. When it went to 8,300, we have to move our strike. So here, somewhere here, around 1 o'clock of 20th. Okay, we have to move our strike. 1 o'clock. So here, I'll move on this. We are on still on 19th. And we go next day on 28th. So we are sitting on a profit here. And then we have to move our strike by 200 points. 8,500 to 8,300. So 29.25, we exit this. So 18,300 call. So now here we got a signal reversal around 21 close, almost at close time. So there was at this point of time, there was no point because, you know, we are already market is at the, we are at expiry. So we'll go till expiry and see how much profit or loss we made. So next day we go here. And then at close, okay, we are sitting around 7,000 of our profit here. So it's simple rule following. Stay with the trend and then change the strike when there is a move of around 200 points. So two or three rules, not too many rules here. So because this was in a very good trend, so we got a very good profit. So on per lot, we have around margin requirement of around 1.1 lakh to 1.2 lakhs. Okay. So now the same way, we look at 14th October expiry. Okay. So 14th October means the Friday will be around 8th of 9:30. So we change this to this. And then we'll go and check what is the market was like. So this 9:15 close will be around 9:30, right? The 9:15 signal, the bar. So this is above supertrend. So we have to sell a put option in this case. So we sell a put option. So the price is around 18,200. So we can sell around 18,200 or 300, around 50 delta basically. So I may, yeah. Sorry, I have to look at it. Okay. Okay, actually it's signal is sell at this point of time. So, so we have to sell this. The close is around 17,850. So maybe we can sell 17,800 call option. Yeah, maybe 17,900. Okay. So now after this, what has happened here? And again, it has changed.
You can put intraday lines for better visibility if you want.
Okay. Okay, for now, so it has changed by 10:15. It went above the signal. So we go till 10:15 and see if we made any loss. I mean, if you have hit any stop loss or something like that. Okay, so here we changing the trade here. So we exit at 139.2. And at this point of time, it's 17,900. So we sell a put option here. 50 delta, close to 50 delta. Yeah. So I prefer this one.
Okay. Because
liquid, that's all. Okay. So after that, what has happened? So till of 11th of 2:30, around 3. So around 3:15 close. We reverse the trade on 11th. So we simply skip to 11th and go to 3:15. Okay, here. So we are kind of break even here. So here 69.15. So now here the price is around, again, 17,970, so around 18,000. So we'll check. At this point of time, we sell again a call option because the signal is below. So 50 delta, so yeah, maybe we can sell this 18,000. Okay. And after this, again, there was a reversal around 2:30. Okay, 2:15. So the close signal will be around 2:30 on the same day, on 12th. Sorry. Yeah, the next day, 2:30. We go to 2:30. Okay. So here again, we are not losing much. 74.1. So since you are in a stock, in a sideways market, imagine if you have done this with a long call options or a long put options. Mm-hmm. We would have lost a lot on theta at this point of time.
Mm-hmm.
So now here, so 18,000. So again, a reversal signal. So we sell a put option here. So we can choose 18,000 put. And then after this, let's see. So till 14th of close, there is nothing. So till expiry, we are fine. So we go to till close. So now we got around 4,600. So even in sideways market, so we have changed how many times? four times total. Three times. And we are still sitting on profit because of the way we have done the structuring of the trade. So we are, because we sold options, we are not losing on theta. Okay, even if there is, you know, theta depreciation, we are actually benefiting from that in the sideways market because we have sold the option.
Okay.
So we have benefited in the trending market. We also benefited in a sideways market.
Okay.
And that is the reason we have to sell options when the market, when the VIX is above 14. When we sell options, the risk here is that if there is a sudden and big reversal.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So let's say we are, you know, in a sell position here.
Mm-hmm.
And if tomorrow market gapped up and open, you know, somewhere around 200 points and above, that will be a big risk. And that is something we have to accept. Nothing that we can do. So that is why it's important that you keep your position size smaller. So don't go on and do some 100 lots or something like that. So keep it very small, depending on how much your capital is available. So don't risk too much. So please be aware of the risk when you sell an option. So this gap risk will always be there. So be aware of that. So that's all, Prashant, from me. If you have any questions.
Just a couple of things, Raghunath. First of all, see, this is an excellent strategy in a way, because the major problem with trend following indicators is you end up making money during strong trends, but the sideways market is a major problem.
Yes.
So you have shown a way out that you can take advantage, you can look at VIX and treat this particular indicator by buying or selling options according to the volatility. And then you can benefit from in sideways market as well. You might and this is also an interesting indicator to do that, because super trend takes into account ATR, which is also a factor of volatility.
Yes.
No, so in moving averages or other trend following indicators, it only considers price. Here you also have ADR. So the curve has to do a lot with the volatility as well. ADR is a volatility.
Yes.
So that's interesting. The two things. Have you tried selling options at the super trend level instead of looking at 50 delta, which is more or less ATM?
Yes. Yes.
So have you tried that or observed it?
Using some other instrument or some other delta?
No. For example, you are selling option at 50 delta. You sell option when the super trend indicator is. I mean, if the level that super trend indicator is shown.
Yes.
So something like that. I mean, more or less it can be around the money, but because. In the strong trend, super trend level might get protected.
Yes, yes.
So instead of selling at 50, what if we do at super trend level itself, something like that?
Okay. Yeah, so we can try that.
All right.
Yeah, I have not tried that, but yeah.
I have. And second is when volatility increases and if there is a strong trend, can also be good for buying option, right? Of course, because this is ideal selling option. But
yes.
If trend is so, how would you consider trading spreads instead of simply buying or selling options?
Spreads can be done, but again, in that case, you know, you'll have two positions, and if you do that, then you know the churning might be more. For example, if somebody is doing intraday, then he has to shift too many strikes, or you know, if he has to change the trade from, you know, buy spread to sell spread, then you know, then the transaction charges and those things, slippages, they can, you know, rack up. So, and for that reason, you know, I used only in a most simple way. But as you said, that, you know, one can consider that, you know, if the VIX is keep on going up, then one can convert that into a spread to protect from to protect from increase in volatility. That is one possibility. But for most part, I think we should be fine for most part. Because, you know, the huge changes in volatility will happen. It will take some time. Or when there's a huge gap up, then that will happen.
Okay.
And when that happens, you obviously hit a stop loss, first of all. So you'll always, you already get out of the trade automatically.
Right.
So, yeah.
All right. I think that's it. So I would also like to talk on quickly explain a setup for trading volatility based on price patterns. Today, I'll quickly discuss a setup for trading volatility based on the price setup. So I'll not be usually we try to take a call on direction and try to analyze the markets using price patterns and charts. But here is a quick discussion how we can also take a call on volatility irrespective of direction. So basically, there are two types of cycles in the market. One is of volatility. So we see that there is a cycle of volatility of expansion and contraction on all instruments and all time frames. I think it is inevitable. There's also a cycle of trend, and I think both overlaps, but we'll discuss trends some other time. So volatility, the expansion is like big volatile market, and contraction is a narrow sideways market or there's a less volatility. There can be a trend during less or more volatile in the market, or there can be simply no trend but more of a volatility. So when we see the price chart, basically how we can analyze the narrow market or sideways market. So this can be a price patterns where we can read contracting volatility where volatility is decreasing. This is expansion. So for example, if this is a chart, this is kind of contracting volatility. Here the swings are decreasing, isn't it? So this was a big swing, and then there were the size of swing or the length of swing moves. So this is just one swing, and then this is a swing. So this is maybe you can call it a triangle pattern or any other pattern. That's not the pattern could be you can give it any other name. This is a multi-resistance pattern. But the whole idea is here the volatility is contracting. And what we can expect is once you have seen this kind of market where the price swings are narrowing, it can be followed by expansion. Because normally, and I have seen studied a lot of instruments on multiple time frames, usually what happens is a narrow or dull phase is followed by a strong trend and vice versa. So that's what we are trying to anticipate. We can anticipate that volatility will increase, and we can plan strategy accordingly. Now this is a price setup. But what happens is this price setup is what we can read, and we can analyze this on any instrument on different time frames, but it's difficult to make it a bit objective. Let's try and do it. Let's try to make things more objective and study the data. So, for example, this is one candle, and this would be a setup. For example, this is a weekly candle. When you have one major candle, it could be green or red, but it shows that the range was high, followed by a smaller range comparatively. Then another candle, which is, so you can call this as inside call candle, saying that this is an inside candle and this is an inside candle. So these four candles are telling us that the volatility is decreasing. Now the range of the market is decreasing. So it is, if then we can perhaps study the things and take a call that volatility might increase. But the other thing is, this is a time-based market, and it is difficult to read this kind of setup on the daily chart, daily candlestick chart, because then next you get candles which can be expanding, but it is limited to a particular. The same thing we can try and see on the pointed figure chart, which is nothing but a price, a different way of representing the price. But what happens is on a P&L chart, even if you don't know much, this is a column of X, or column of X is bullish, column of O is bearish. But a column shows a particular swing instead of one time-based price. This is, as long as price is bullish, it remains in the column of X. So you can have a multiple sessions in the same column. You have a starting date, end date, and then some particular price swing. So the same thing that we saw in candlestick chart can be converted in P&L chart. Now here what happens is you have this one swing followed by inside swing instead of inside candle, right? So this is this swing is higher. The second swing, we let's call it inside column, and this inside column is the range is comparatively less. Same thing is followed by another inside column and then another inside column. Now the swings are contracting, and this is the volatility is decreasing. The every price swing is lesser compared to its previous price. So in the center price pattern, this is known as a four column triangle, because there are four columns and the center phase of conversion. This is known as a four column triangle. So this is kind of a volatility contraction or the price convergence, right? So there can be multiple columns in this setup, and you need not know much about all this, but here is an interesting point. Now see, this is a three column setup, price setup. So for example, there are three columns, and it is also a setup that shows contraction. Same way, this is a four column triangle that we discussed. There can be five columns and multi column triangles. So all these multiple columns in this setups shows us the pattern of contraction. Now what we expect here is, if we talk about the strategy, how we trade this, particularly using options, we expect expansion, all right? So we say that in price setup words, we say that there can be, it can be followed by a breakout, but breakout can be a direction. I mean, we can of course trade that also, but in a very simple words, we expect that there was a contraction, there was a setup of price convergence. Now there is a possibility of strong trend. Either ways, bullish or bearish, we may not know the direction. So how do we define this? How do we say that this pattern of triangle is over? It is ending. So the definition can be, this is a series of inside columns. This is inside column 1, this is inside column 2, this is 3. If the next column is not an inside column, the triangle is over. I mean, this is a breakout. Why this is not an inside column? Because the length or this move or the high price of this column of X above its previous X. So this is a breakout, and this is not beating this previous column. So this is not an inside column, and that is why the pattern of convergence is over, and now we have a breakout, now we have a trend. Okay, so this is how we can simply define it. It would be the triangle could have been this way also, OXOX followed by another rule. So it depends. Once we know this, let's quickly have a look at an interesting data. So before we move on to what we need to see is what is the probability of that expansion. I'll quickly show you something. See, This is a backtesting of all F&O stocks since 1990. The pattern is three column triangle. And this is an entry column, this is an exit column, this is column reverse. Now here what the whole idea is, we are not trying to backtest the triangle, that's a separate subject. Here the idea is, if I see this is whole F&O universe and all stocks since inception, just see the total number of stocks. Here there is another other information as well, APTs, average profitable trades, ALTs, average losing trades and all that. But this is 34,577. So these are the total number of occurrences, right? Now I change it to triangle football. And let's scan. So now we are scanning all of the stocks since inception, and now the occurrences are 9,157. So these are the four column triangle patterns, which are not really a three column triangle. And let's quickly also scan five column triangle. So now what we are doing here is we are just looking at total occurrences. It is 1781. Now simply if you see almost 26% three column triangles are converted to four column triangles. Same way, almost 19% or almost 20% triangles, four column triangles are converted to five column triangles. What does it show? So basically, this is a three column triangle. The information that we have is three column triangles are converted 26% times it is converted to four column triangle. That means about 75% of time you get a breakout, right? From four column triangle to five column triangle, roughly about 20% of four column triangles are converted to five column triangle. That means 80% of time you get breakout. Now this becomes an important information. How? So this is, as I said, this could be a bullish breakout or a bearish. Bullish or bearish is not we are going to see here, but this could be XOXO or OXOX. Both are known as pattern of contraction or triangle. Now, the strategy that I want to explain is we need to act here. The moment we enter into the fourth column of a triangle, here we need to trade option. Okay? Now, because this is a bullish or bearish, I have just simply shown it by these lines. So this is the fourth column. There are three possibilities after this. Number one, it can turn out to be a five column triangle. The probability is roughly around 20%. Number two, you can get a breakout here only. This can be a bullish breakout or a bearish breakout in the fourth column only. Right? So after, but that will also be a direction, which is what we want. We want volatility expansion or the breakup. So that is also a favorable scenario and roughly about 75%. But since we have entered into the fourth column itself, the probability increases. So mostly 75% to 80% chances are there that they will get a breakout in this column you will get the breakout in the next column. It will turn out to be a four column triangle breakout. So after this fourth column, there will be a breakout in the fifth column. So 80% chance of happening this. So roughly, the whole idea is, to put it in very simple words, once you see a four column triangle breakout and you try to enter, the chances are more, as per the historical studies, about 75%, 80% of the probability that you will get a breakout in that column or the next column itself. This is the information that we have from this setup. And why this? Here, what happens is it is very objective. You know this four column triangle, there is no subjectivity. So, anything here is kind of easy. Now, see this chart. And this is a chart of Maruti till Thursday. And since I prepared it that day, so see this is 1, 2, 3, and 4. So, these are four column triangles. we need to add here. All right, we need to buy option. We'll discuss the strategy that I have, but this is a four column. Same way, this is a four column trend. All right, so this is a four column trend. So the whole idea of this could have been a four column triangle right now. Right now it looks a three column triangle breakout, but it's possible that it could get the opportunity here. Because see this chart, I'll show the current chart of Maruti. Before that, so this is 1, 2, 3, 4. Here you get an objective setup. This is still Thursday. So here you got a breakout. Right? So this now it looks a three column triangle breakout, but it was a four column triangle. So the whole idea is we act. I'll show another example of the Thursday itself. So this was a four column triangle where now we got a breakout. So this could be the triangle pattern is kind of objective, which it shows that there is a pattern of contraction and we can bet on the expansion. We discussed about the possibility. The whole thing is what we can do. We can simply go to the scalar. There is a for example, F&O universe. You can just scan for four column triangle. You get the stocks. You see if they are liquid in options, and you might look for strategies for buying options. There's also a group for option liquid instruments. You can run it on that. But this is where you get the list of stocks, and you can try trade for option strategy. Now, how can we improve the chances further? Is as Raghunath said earlier, if the base is low or the IV is low for that particular instrument, so the premiums are affordable, and you can trade buying option strategy. The strategies could be buying straddle strangle or debit spread or calendar diagonal spread, etc. I mean, you can you get benefited if the volatility increases. That's going to be our bet. And then so people who know about methods and they can analyze the charts, they can improve their odds by trading based on the biases or the anticipation of the direction of the breakout. For example, if the last column is of O, and I anticipate that there will be a bullish breakout based on the chart, etc. So for example, the current chart, I'm not sure how liquid this is in options, but this is a four column triangle, and overall chart is kind of bullish, right? So overall setup is very bullish. Now if I anticipate that the direction is going to be bullish, then we can think of writing puts, and of course we can decide on those things looking at situation of volatility. So that's it from my side. If you have any question, we can discuss, Raghunath, or we can conclude.
Yeah, it's a very interesting, Prashant.
Yeah.
I mean, it's a very nice way to take long volatility trades, okay, or sometimes maybe even directional trades in this case.
Okay.
Because at some point of time, you know that, you know, when you're at three column or four column or four, five column breakout,
okay,
that whatever expansion that might happen, it might happen in one particular direction, right?
Yeah.
So, I mean, once that breakout happens, maybe we can take directional as well. And if you're somebody who don't know that whether it's going to go up or down, then you can take long volatility, you know, where you buy both long, the long straddle or long strangle. Right. Yes.
Right. So, while presenting this, I assume that also there is an angle here, because people think that mostly chart is for analyzing about direction. There are a lot of people who don't want to trade direction; they want to trade volatility, for example, in options. So, from that perspective, also this can be useful. People who know the method of analysis can anticipate the direction.
Okay. Yeah.
Isn't it?
Yes.
I just hope that of course we are seeing a lot of volume and increasing in options, if we get more liquid instrument in options, best scenario, because these kind of strategies will be very tradable. That's that you can have more liquidity, depth in options.
That's true. Yeah, it's very interesting. I mean, I should try and see do some kind of simulation. We can structure these option strategies and benefit from that.
Correct. That will be very interesting. And you know what happens is because of this swing objectivity, let's forget T&M as a charting method. Because of this objectivity or swings we have. Now, see, this backtesting was not about whether the strategy is profitable or not. It was about the occurrences, right?
Yes.
So, I have done this in a lot of patterns on P&L charts, on Renko charts. So, what happens is you get to know about the probability of the next column or the next swing that we have, right?
Yes.
There is also a possibility of designing strategies accordingly.
Yes. So there is like you know, when you said, you know, when you move from 3 to 4 column, there is around 26% probability.
Correct.
So there is a chance that 26% chance of staying, you know, within that range.
Yes.
And expansion, there is 75% of chance of expansion.
Correct.
So accordingly, you can structure and see, you know, what works.
Yeah,
that's interesting.
Yeah.
That's nice, Prashant. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you, Rukna. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you.
Bye.
Okay, bye.